Alright, in this video, we're going to be going over a bar cocktail defense, as requested by a viewer. Now, as opposed to going over a default strategy, which most people have an idea of, and if you don't, that's okay, I want to go over a specific NIP defense that I think provides some interesting variations and ideas to play off of. And it's built on the default defense anyway, so let's get into it. Alright, now let's go over the site setup. On the cocktail side, we've got a pretty default setup. You've got your rotate to C3, shoot out the little railings, and that allows you to run quickly to heaven, and also rotate with a protected line of sight into the below skylight area, as well as this reinforcement, which protects the C3 player. You also got your line of sight on this wall, which allows you to hop on the C1 bench and watch default plant. And of course, you've got the reinforcement here, and a rotate into freezer, and you want it on this side because it means they can't shoot you while rotating when they're on skylight. However, on the piano side, NIP has done some things differently, right? Reinforcing these two walls of freezer is pretty default. However, they fully reinforce off bathroom, and I'll explain that in a little bit. They've also done a default ticket wall reinforcement, and you do want that. And from the bathroom perspective, they reinforce the left side of bathroom wall and piano and place a deployable shield with a line of sight specifically for the deployable shield. And additionally, you've got a full wall-to-wall line of sight onto the Nubalk walk-in from Pixel. All right, now that we've gone over reinforcements and rotates, let's talk about utility. So this defense is based around the concept of holding piano and leveraging that to pressure the attackers as they try to push it or push Nubalk. This is pretty susceptible to a cocktail take, so be on the look for that and make sure to rotate the defenders early if you sense that's coming. Now, to protect piano, one of the reasons that you can't typically play in piano is because of the south, the west, and the ticket windows. So what they've done is they've stacked castle barricades and Aruni gates on all of these windows into piano. And additionally, they've provided a bulletproof here to give intel if the attackers do end up taking piano. So these castle barricades and Aruni gates mean that attackers have to spend a significant amount of utility to gain enough angles to effectively clear a piano player. Because not only do you have to clear the castle barricade, but you have to clear the Aruni gate if you want to use any throwables to push them out of areas that you don't have a line of sight on. And having a rotate to trains means that the defender playing in this position can play here for long enough to waste utility and waste a ton of time. And then if he needs to fall back, he should just drop here and rotate up the white stairs. Now the other part of this defense that isn't true to default is we have this cigar hold. So Castle uses his fourth castle barricade on the double door between piano and cigar, and this protects the cigar player behind a deployable shield. This deployable shield is used to hold the red walk-in and Nubalk. And the final component of this defense is the bathroom setup. Instead of reinforcing the right wall and having a line of sight on the left, you've done the reverse, and you set a deployable shield behind the line of sight with an ADS protecting it. Now what this means is that if you have a line of sight from these corner windows, the bathroom player is protected from the reinforcement because it's now on the left. And because the line of sight is now on the right with the deployable shield, the bathroom player can actually watch the ticket window and the ticket walk-in. And the piano player can concern themselves with these two windows and fall back if needed. Now, another thing to notice is that the castle barricade here gets prepped, and this means that the defender playing in cigar can use it to protect him from a line of sight if the attackers get piano control, but can also pop it open if he wants to support the piano player, or if another defender needs to retake the sight and is rotating in from piano to cigar. Alright, so now it's time to talk about the lineup, and we've briefly gone over who the operators are going to be, but just to clarify, we're going to be running a Goyo, a Castle, a Mozzie, a Jager, and an Aruni. And we'll go through what each of them does in the prep phase and how they play throughout the round. So, starting with Goyo, Goyo's only real utility to set up is his two shields. He's going to have one in cigar and one in bathroom. So that frees him up to set up a decent amount of reinforcements during the prep phase. I've outlined some here, but feel free to do more if you feel like you can. Now, because he has the Vector and the Nitro Cell, I think he's really well suited to playing behind the cigar shield, and that's where Nip has him as well. So his job is to play here as long as he can, to make sure players can't walk in for free from red and from Nubalk, and if needed, he can pop the castle barricade and support a piano player if that's necessary. Now, on the other hand, Castle has a decent bit more utility set up, so he's not going to be doing any reinforcing. He's got a castle barricade, the ticket window, the south and west windows, and the double barricade, as well as placing his bulletproof camera and making a line of sight wall-to-wall on the trash wall. After he's done that, he's going to play on the bathroom deployable shield. Now, this isn't an ideal situation, because obviously the ump isn't a fantastic gun, but as you can see in this clip, that's where NIP has him positioned, and his 1.5 does mean he can technically take those gunfights, even if his gun doesn't deal the most damage. Aruni's going to be responsible for setting up a little bit of utility, reinforcing a little, and making site construction. Obviously, we need someone else to make the rotate into C3, since Castle will be occupied the whole prep base, and someone to make a line of sight into bathroom for the Goyo deployable shield. Now, Aruni is unique in that her one-punch melee allows her to one-punch barricades, and on Cafe, this is going to prove especially useful for performing runouts. Runouts are really the only way that defenders are able to effectively counter repels, so she's actually going to play below in dining, trains, and mining, and roam as the other defenders call for her to run out on certain repels. She may not end up needing to run out, but if she does, it's helpful to have her there in position to get some free picks and waste time for the attackers. However, it's important for her not to play too aggressive. At the end, she should eventually fall back to site, probably up the white stairs, and help either in Freezer or Cocktail. Now, Mozzie doesn't really have much utility to set up at all, so he's going to do a lot of the reinforcing, especially in Freezer. And if the other teammates need help, he can also fill in there because he has plenty of time, and Jager will as well. Both of them can really help reinforce. With the pest set up, the goal of the pest is to deny information on the cigar and piano room. So we're going to have a pest on the door from red into cigar, one on the little hallway from Newbout to the default plant, and the final one in to ticket. And these, again, are designed to deny the attackers from having easy information on where the defenders are playing in piano and cigar. Once the prep phase is done, Mozzie is going to play in piano. Either the Roni or Commando are both guns with significant fragging potential, so having the nitro cell and those guns naturally suits Mozzie to play this aggressive position and fall back when he gets pushed out. Lastly, we have Jager, and Jager doesn't really have any utility to place down as well in terms of the amount of time it would take him, so he can help out with reinforcements again, just like I mentioned during the Mozzie section. Jager has two places of barbed wire, so we're going to place one on the white stairs and one on the red stairs into cigar walk-in. We want these sound cues to alert defenders if anyone's trying to sneak in unnoticed. We're going to place an ADS in bathroom, an ADS in cigar, and finally an ADS under the skylight to protect the Shiko spot. The two ADSs in red and bathroom protect deployable shields, as we've mentioned previously. Outside of that, Jager is free to do what he wants, and when the prep phase is over, Jager should play in C3, making sure that he's able to hold down the bar and cocktail side of sight. So that's the strategy. I think it's viable in ranked, just like it is in Pro League, because it provides an interesting twist on the ranked default. If you would like to see a more traditional default setup, please comment that below, and comment what other strategies for different maps you'd like to see. I have more strategies upcoming for Outback, so make sure to subscribe if you want to see those, and I hope this video was helpful to you.